So with the arrival of October, we also have the arrival of fall color season here in Indiana for our native hardwood trees. Several things come into play when it comes to determining the colors that we find on the leaves of our trees, and we'll talk about that today. So several pigments are found in the leaves of trees. The green that we typically see through the summer months is chlorophyll, which is central to the photosynthesis process. But also underneath that green, there are several other pigments that can be found. And also at the end of the season, once the chlorophyll starts to degrade, we have some other pigments that may develop. And so we have two species here, flowering dogwood on the left-hand side, really beautiful reds and maroons, and redbud on the right-hand side, which still has some of its green leaves, still showing a lot of chlorophyll, but also some yellow leaves. And so we're going to start with our redbud. What we got now is trees go through a process called leaf obsision, and that is determined by a change in day length and night length. So as our days get shorter, our nights get longer, there's a chemical change that happens in the tree that starts forming an obsision layer or division layer between the leaves and the stems. This is accompanied by gradual breakdown in chlorophyll. And so once the chlorophyll starts breaking down, we actually start seeing some of the pigments that are present underneath that green chlorophyll. And one of the yellows, and also can be sometimes a shade of orange, are the carotenoids. And so what we're seeing here with these yellow leaves are carotenoid pigments showing through as that chlorophyll pigment breaks down in the leaves of redbud. However, we do have some other pigments that have actually developed in the fall of the year. And they're oftentimes based off of glucose compounds. And so one of them is anthocyanin. The anthocyanins produce colors in the reds, maroons, and purples. And so plants that tend to produce these, we oftentimes get these brilliant red or purple fall color displays like we see here with flowering dogwood. In addition to those two pigments, we also have a long-lasting material in the plants, and that is tannins. And so when we actually have the pigments all die on the leaves of the trees and degrade, the brown that is left behind are the tannins. And these are long-lasting and persistent, and so that's why we see those brown leaves on the forest floor in the fall. So a combination of these pigments is what helps develop the color we see displayed in our fall foliage.